Hello there everyone, and welcome back to Nova Aetis. We're actually in Pravin right now, and well, I've gone ahead, and since last time, I've played a bit off camera. And so I've established quite a few businesses. Now we do have the bakery here in Pravin, but now I have a blacksmith in Suno, and I also have here in Aldurius, I have a carpenter's shop. We can go through my personal report here. Let's see. My character report. No, it's my budget that we want to go through. The budget. And then we can see I have my mill in Pravin, my carpenter in Andalurians, and a blacksmith in Suno. Now, I don't make a lot of money from these places. So I'm thinking off to the side here where I don't really need anything special or any. I think in, because I've got, you can build a tailor as well, so I think I'm gonna keep all these places quite close to each other, and then I'm gonna make a dye works out here, because well, normally they make quite a lot of money, so I'm hoping that I can make quite a lot of money from that. Anyways, there's been so many comments throughout the latest videos. Through all of them about war, but I think that the specialty that this mod does is the prestige thing, so it would be all kind of odd that you ask for that, but then you go for the like simp, but then everyone asking for like the simplest thing that you can do in every mod there is out there, and so it feels kind of strange if I would just completely ignore the prestige system and not go through that, try to learn that, and instead just beat stuff over the head with, you know, sticks and stuff. Anyways, we will go to war at some point, but I wanna still go ahead and do a lot with the, what we can do is when I can actually go to the blacksmith. And we can take a look there. One thing though is the mining thing. I did not, after doing quite a bit of mining, I found that it was not very satisfying to do mining, because the smelting part ruined a lot of it, because I was missing up to over 50% of the times I wanted to smelt the thing into something useful. And then when I realized that to build tools I needed steel, and then you need the iron bars, you needed to smelt them, and then the risk, of course. So probably I won't be doing any more mining, because that's, I can't see how that's useful in any way or shape. It's just going to take loads of time, when I just as well can go ahead and gather money and then buy the necessary equipment. Anyways, you can build quite the good tools in there, with quite the good swords and stuff. And I've seen quite a fair bit of swords, like, not this one, but let's go through here a bit. And you've got swords that got, like this one, has 60 in swing, 53 in thrust. This is bloody amazing, I must say. And although you need a lot more crafting to make these, you can make quite good swords, because I've got 4 in crafting, so that's good. But I'm probably gonna need a lot more to make better swords. The current one I have is rather good, and the carpentry is, well, some of the parts there, like these handles and stuff, you need carpentering to make. You can buy them, but it's obviously cheaper. And carpentering, unlike the metalworks, is a lot easier, because there's no risk of you destroying that stuff, as far as I know. I haven't actually started doing that, but just shaping the wood into stuff that you can use doesn't seem that terrible. Now, I've got this great bassinet because there seem to be tournaments all the time. And so 53 is pretty darn good. So I've got pretty good stats on my swords, and look at this balanced greatsword that I have. 45 in swing and 36 in thrust, so that's pretty good. And then a heavy bastard sword because I want to use it with the shield. And then a flanged mace because capturing people and then releasing them either for, as you know, for payment or just releasing them so you get prestige is pretty darn good. What we're going to do is, of course, we need more prestige because I need to get into the gentry, and hopefully then the king will grant me to be part of the Swadians, and they will give me some territory. And then, since you can actually build your own castle, I was thinking once I get my own village, I could build my castle next to that. You can build up to 6 castles, so there's no problem with that. So hopefully we'll be able to do that. But one thing, let's see. So for my character, I've actually managed to become friends with the Viscount, the Count of Suno, which I think is good. A few enemies here that, well, I burned these villages when I was in the Holy Land. My prestige is 800, and I need just 19 more to get to the next level, which is the bourgeoisie. I get into, so yeah. And then after that, then is when we hit the gentry, the first part of the gentry class, where we actually is considered a proper nobleman. But already a lot of these lords know about me because of my fame, not only in the tournament ring, but from taking down the heretic sites and fighting some of the heretics in the Holy Land as well. So I am famous in that way, and I'm probably famous also for my businesses that I've set up. They're not particularly profitable, but I'm probably a bit known in those circles as well. Anyways, what I wanted to be, someone said that I should do the Great Aqueduct, and I should repair that. Now, the Great Aqueduct, you get 500 while you get 300 in this. And you need so much more to build the Great Aqueduct, because I think you need 60 pieces of, 60 pieces of marble, which is a lot more expensive than the 30 ones you need here. So, and you don't get that much more prestige from doing that. Let's go ahead and go to my property, because I'm storing a lot of it there. And what I remember is you need 10 of each to be able to buy or to start the production of that. And we're going to go up here and we're going to go inside, and there's my box. And so here's my Mastercraft stuff. This is a cabinet, apparently. I don't know if you can see that, but that's very poorly made cabinet, or the masterpiece. Maybe I should sell that masterpiece, because you could get quite a bit of cash from that. I also found this. I think I was mentioned that in another, that I picked up a firelock pistol. But I'm thinking I'm going to give it to one of my companions or something, and then we'll go greatsword. I've got 10 wood. I've got more than 10 stone. I've got 10 slabs of marble. The only thing I miss is 10 tools. Now I've got 6 of them, and I was hoping I was going to be able to, you know, make my own tools. But looking at the way, and it's going to take so long to make a bar of steel to be able to make the tools, so it's probably best maybe to just buy tools, or buy steel maybe. But there we have it. So we need, I had 6, and so we need 4 more tools. Before I can go ahead, we can trade with the guild. What is bar of steel is 381. Do they have any tools? Let's see what the cost of tools is. So this tool is 30 tools, 620, which is quite a bit more expensive. But I think you can get just pretty decent tools for around the same price that I can get for the bar of steel. So I think it's best just to go ahead and do that. So let's just go ahead around here and see if we can buy the tools so I can make that. And then with all the cash or all the prestige, I'm hopefully be able to maybe push through the next level and get into the gentry. The thing is, I was already actually asked when I was in the Holy Land by the Serenids to join them. But that would be kind of weird, I thought, since my character is Christian. He's Catholic. We should have, yeah. I gained some more trains here. Open-minded I was before, and bad duelist, you know about that. But now I'm good-looking. Bose looks that most men would kill to have when courting ladies. Lord, plus 500 influence points upon marrying him. Train Tolder, 500 plus influence upon marrying someone. So I gain influence points, which is good. And then I have this taint, pious. This person leads an honest life and addressed in religious matter with importance, the importance they demand. 50% battle advantage benefit from tactics skill only against lords of different beliefs. So this will be good when the crusade comes around, because a lot of people has been talking about the crusade and stuff. And hopefully maybe when we go on a crusade, I could capture castle in the Holy Land. We're 18. I'm not sure if this actually increases as we go along. But hopefully it does. Let's go ahead and see if we can't buy some tools here. Do you have any tools? No. Well, then we can head over to the Vatican and we can take a look at my carpentry shop, which I set up. And maybe we can build some stuff, because I could quite easily get some wood. You know what? I should probably ask to be able to forage wood from this forest as well. Buying a charter wasn't that expensive. A messenger is allowed to pass in your bag. He leaves the sealed letter. Can Olaf Forkbeard a tournament? So the king invites me to a tournament, so we more or less have to go to that. Unless we want to piss off a king, which I do not intend. It seems there's a tournament all over the place right now. But let's go ahead and visit my carpenter shop, where I actually have my own apprentice, apparently. Hello there, apprentice! Good day, master! And we got all sorts of funny tools going around here. So we got this thing to, shape this piece, and we can saw this in two, and this one, and so on. Anyways, let's go to the workbench and see what we can actually make. So we can make a few cabinets and stuff that I guess is good for... we can make pistols. But I think trade goods looks rather funny. That we can make some of these different types of stools and carving panels and whatnot. But also bows. A crossbow would be good, maybe. Or something like that, to be able to make that for companions. Arrows and bolts, shields, flintlock pistols. I'm not entirely sure though how you make the barrel, but I imagine we can make one. Oh, a blunderbuss. That's interesting. But maybe, as there is a sort of a technology advance in this mod, so the factions will progress as we go along. Hello there. Yes. No, I have nothing to talk with you. What we can do is we can go through the chest, and we have some timbers here. And let's see if we can... Not entirely sure why we have pottery and water in here. But let's go ahead and see if we can't make something out of this. And maybe we can make maybe not a chair, because... Well, for this, let's say we're going to make a chair. Or another cabinet. A chair. Let's say we're going to make a chair. So we need four of these wooden legs and two wood panels. So here we got wooden legs, which I actually need a full timber thing for. So since I only had four, that means that we have to craft... No. Please finish correct crafting process. Okay, crafting has started. Right. Okay. Ah, and now I have to go through. Ah, so, oh, yes. This is cool. So, this is the same thing I have to do when I do my smithing. So, then it will explain in which way I have to go. Anyways, let's start off with this then. So, we're going to make this piece. And we're going to saw this beam off. This is quite extensive, though. So, now I've got this piece. And now I need to shape this. In this thing. I'm not entirely sure what it's called, but in Swedish, svarv. And now we've... Oh, look at that. It even looks like... I mean, this mod is amazing, I must say. I'm not entirely sure what we're holding that in the hand over there. Piece of bread or something? I'm not sure. But look at that. It even looks... And it... That's pretty darn amazing. This mod is pretty amazing. And the people just, whoa, I want war instead. Can't you do war? Can't you do war? Can't you just become king and kill people? And we'll have to go through all these funny stuff. Anyways, let's apply varnish. Okay, so we're gonna sit here. And we're gonna we're gonna polish this thing. And boom! We're done! And I gained some prestige points. You know what? We can push to the bourgeoisie just by going ahead and doing... We're gonna make another one. Let's make another one. So I've started that again. And... Oh, it magically reappears and then we cut it in two. I didn't need that many points. You know what I can do? We can go ahead and do this, but then I can jump to the point where I'm actually gonna make the chair. Oh, but what, Cedric, where are you? Cedric's somewhere in here and he's looking at me and he's like, "Oh, I gained some life experience by watching my master polish this." This chair leg. Anyways, let's go ahead and see if I can't jump to the point where we're gonna assemble the chair. Okay, so we're back. I've gathered the last pieces of wood, and now we're gonna make the seat of the chair, and then hopefully we'll be able to assemble this thing. So now I've got... I like the fact that you even get, like, what the piece is supposed to look like, in a way. And that the process changed around, so in this case we need to smooth the panel. I mean, the amount of details and stuff that put into this mod is quite amazing. And now we're putting varnish on it. And now I should have enough to make... Yes! Now I can make the chair! How very lovely. Now let's craft it! Do you wish to sell your crafted item to the town for 490... This result in an estimated profit of 216. You can keep the item, but the guild does no longer guarantee a fixed selling price for this item. You know what? It's my first chair... unlike my masterpiece, which looks like absolute trash, so I'm gonna keep this. I'm gonna keep my chair. And I should have been able, let's see, personal report, character report, and class information. Yes, I should have been able now to progress to the next level. Let's go ahead and take a look at my chair, by the way. So, oh! This, it says a selling price of 750. So the... They wanted to sell it for... I can sell it for 750. Why did they... They said they would sell it for 400 and something. I can sell this chair for 750. That's a lot more. You know what? The carpentry stuff would is quite good. Because if I go to the woods, I can, you know, without more or less... paying anything, I can just cut down as many trees as I want, and I can take this and I can shape it into stuff like this, and I can make loads of profit. So in that way, it's quite profitable. It's same as with the bread, in a way, that I'm be able to just make all the flour and then put it in there, and I only have to pay for some of the other stuff. Here we got some tools, 400, and you know what, since I made quite a bit of money from doing that, let's buy these tools. So now I only need 3 more tools. Steel. You know what? How about we make some tools. We got steel here, so what I need is a handle. That steel wasn't actually very expensive. So what we need to go back to the carpentry. We need to make a handle, I believe. So let's go ahead and see. Where do we have trade goods? Is it trade goods? No, intermediates. We need a handle. This is a pole. Is it a heft? The heft, I believe, is what we're supposed to make. So we're going to craft a heft. We need to saw the piece, and then we'll head over to the smithy, and then we can go through the same kind of thing through the smithy. Okay, so now we need to shape it, and then I need my aid of my apprentice to run this through. And then what do we do now with it? Now we saw the pole. And then we varnish it. And there we go. We have a heft. Now, over to the smithy in Suno to complete it and make a pair of tools. Good morrow. You've gained more and more power and prestige. Lords, keep track on you. Welcome to the bourgeoisie. Which is very good. How much do I actually need then to progress to the next level? If it were to be 300 points, which it actually is, I need 300 points. So when I will be able to create or restore this, that will be enough to push me into the gentry, so the first class there. Sarenids have declared war on the Kirkits. You know, this so-called Mongol invasion did not do very well. The Mongols, all the territory they captured through here was retaken, and the thing they were able to hold on is this area right here. So they hold 2 castles in this area right there. So not very impressive, but apparently they're supposed to kick in another gear, apparently, someone said. But we'll see about that. So let's go to the blacksmithy and see if we can make some tools. Workbench up, yes. Tool, or heft, and steel. So, let's craft this. Do you wish to sell your crafted item? Oh, so, that's kind of unfortunate. The fact that I wasn't able to go through. We need something. We need something to go through a process here. I'll keep it, because I need it. So, what I'll do is go... What should we make then? Let's see. What should we make? Some sword or something. Something that we can actually go through. I think we need to make something like this. So we need a piece of steel to make like a handle. And then we can go through and actually see the process here. Or maybe a sword's blade. Sword's blade would be cool. Yes. So I need another piece of steel. Hopefully they'll sell one in town. If I'm lucky. The guild might want to sell me one piece. Wait, did I get two? No, I bought one, didn't I? Or did I make 2 pieces of tool? No, I bought one. Let's go ahead and see. Steel. Not that bad, not that bad. So, let's go ahead and make a blade, shall we? Let's go back to the blacksmithy. And make ourselves a sword's blade. Sacks? No, not. Handle. Swords blade. Is there like a 2-handed swords blade? Or maybe I can make like a really good firearm barrel. Shield. No, we're gonna make a swords blade. Craft. Okay, so there, take rough iron rod. So now I have the iron rod. Oh, look at that. I even grip it with some pliers. And then we needed to go here. Or did I? Oh, no. I was supposed to go here, I think. Wait, where did the arrow actually point? Or what did it just say, take one over here? And then I was supposed to go over here. Or something. No. Okay, here we go. I missed the fact that it's so... Does this mean that I need to blow on the fire? I think this is blowing on the fire. Yes. We need to get the fire going. Then I heat up the iron rod. And so now it's glowing. Dangerous. And now I need to flatten it over here. Okay, I kind of want to put it in there if it's going to be useful. Okay, there we go. We get this working. Right, and now when I've... Oh, it changed as it changed again. It became flat. And now smithing hammer. And then forge an iron work. Let's make this blade. And now it actually looks like a blade. Now it's going to quench it, so I'm going to warn everyone because this sound is quite high. So let's go ahead and quench the blade. Okay, I thought... Okay, forging the sword requires sufficient mastery. The blade is heated by tempering. Cooling incorrectly caused the blade to break and become worthless crap. With enough care, you can create a beautiful new weapon. Maybe it's because I need more crafting to be able to, you know, because this one moved rather slow. And now I made my blade, and I imagine that I've got a blade somewhere. Or how does this work? Or is it something else? I need some more part. Yes. I need to polish the item. There we go. Now I've got an item. Swords blade. Let's see if we can make the entire sword. I need more steel for that. So let me just jump around and see if I can't make the sword, and we can see if I can get some more steel, and maybe I can make the tools required to start my process of rebuilding the temple. So the last point here of making the handle was to polish it, and now you can see the sword handle. Now I can't make the best sword, but I can make a damned good one. Because let's see. What I want to do is, I'm not entirely sure which is the best one I can make at the current skill. Since I have about 4, so I can't make like the super good ones. So I think the rapier ones are the best ones I can make. So something close to along the lines of these. And I think this one is probably the best one I can make currently. This rapier right here. It's got 46 in swing and 49 in thrust. So let's go ahead and do that, and we're gonna keep it. So let's take a look here. So we got this rapier now. It requires 20 strength to wield. Holy. It's a lot better than my current. It's even better than this. Quite by far. But it needs 20 points of strength to be able to. Anyways, as you can see, I've also made enough tools. So, we should be able to start our restoring of the great piece of thingamajiggy that is out there. And hopefully, I'll be able to progress then. Well, I will be able to start the process. I won't be able to finish it because I'm gonna need some more stuff. But I can easily get more wood, and I can easily get more stone. Tools and marble is going to be a bit more difficult to get. But let's see if we can load up on all the stuff I need. So we need the rest of the tools. So now I've got 10 tools. And then we're going to need 10 pieces of timber. Then we're going to need 10 pieces of stone. Is that... Yes, that's 10 pieces. And then we need 10 pieces of marble. And there we have it. So let's set our sights on the temple to be able to start the process in restoring it and getting enough prestige to push us into the gentry class. We'll start off by, I think, taking a look at it, because I haven't actually shown you guys what it looks like. The thing is, maybe I should have checked the backstory. Who is this goddess and so on? But never mind that. Let's just go ahead and make this. They may post a cross over there, but I imagine this, since it's an old goddess, I imagine it sort of comes from the area where Caladria or Calradia was closer to the Roman Empire. But here it is, here's the temple, and we're gonna start some works on this. So, let's go ahead and do that, shall we? So, restore this structure. Before bringing materials to the site, you need at least 10 units of each, so add 10 timber, add 10 stone, add 10 tools, and 10 marble. Restore the structure, I need 10 more timber, 10 more stone, and 20 more marble. So, the timber and the stone should be fine. Marble, however, is a bit more expensive. So, let me just take the time to gather those materials. And we'll see what happens in the meantime. But marble is going to take a bit of while, so we're going to figure out some way to make money. Which probably means go out and fighting bandits and stuff. We found another of these unholy hideouts. So I'm hoping that we can go ahead and loot this place for quite the good gold and stuff. Hopefully they carry a load of stuff. So I'll be able to use that to buy the necessary equipment to the necessary marble. I need another 20 bricks for that, and that's gonna cost at least, I think, at the bases you can get marble for about 300, I think, like the cheapest ones. But then it's about finding those, so we'll imagine that we are going to have to pay around 6,000, at least 6,000, for the kind of marble we're going to need to fully restore this thing. I could go ahead and make a load of chairs to save up for that money as well. But when I saw this place, well, first of all, it's bloody annoying having these bastards in the way as you progress when you move around to do other stuff. So these guys definitely need to go. This castle needs to be eradicated. And, yeah, there's quite a few guys over here. Let's bring out the big guns. Oh. Well, there's quite a few of them this time. I believe it levels depending on your own level. So more evil people turns up. Also, I found out that the medic that I lost actually has turned up now. And she is moving around in the towns. Seems I've lost all my allies. Let's see, were there any more down here? There's one guy, but I think he's running up there. So. We've got more enemies coming this way. Come here, you bastards! Nope, don't get stuck. Fight me then, you cud! I think I did it. Yes! Well, I completely... There... Yes, it should be mine. Give me the stuff now. And destroy the... Oh, crap. Is that 42? Oh, my God. Oh, no. Oh, this is gonna take a while. Oh, my God. Oh, no. Ah, damn it. 42 of them. Ah, I hate these bastards. And so, I'm back in the blacksmith because, well, I was able to chase down those extremists in the end. Unfortunately, though, I wasn't able to get my helmet back, so we're gonna have to make a new helmet, I think. And I've already made the pieces, so it's all about just choosing which helmet to make. And there's so many of them. The problem is, of course, that I do not have enough skill, really, to make some of the really good ones. So we're gonna have to settle with something middle ground. It seems as though the crafting skill seems to jump around very much, but a lot of the helmets lie on level 10, which is gonna take quite a while for me to achieve. I mean, a Roman helmet would be cool, but I would probably have to have a lot more Roman stuff on me. I would like to have a helmet that has at least 40 plus. We had one there. 43. I don't like the color, though. It's sort of sandish color. Maybe if I would go to the blue one. No, I don't like the blue one either. Do they have any one of these great helmets that are just this one? 39. Let's see if there's another one that maybe has closer to 40. I think 39 is... probably the closest we're gonna get to the one I had. Yeah, it looks like it. Well, this one's 38, but this one's not really the kind of helmet a Svardian lord would use, would he? So let's go back. Let's see if we can find it. There it was. No. There we have it. This one. Crafted! And I will keep it. What can I sell this for? What can I sell? Not a lot. But there we go. Now I've got my own helmet. It doesn't really fit that well. But I guess... Oh, what's this? Letter of Indulgence. Anyways. I was hoping that I could... maybe finish the temple, but one thing that happened is, well, I, as we saw in, I think it was Pravin when I built my bakery, at a certain point, the guild hall was upgraded, and that gave me quite a bit of prestige, and so lucky for me, two of my guild halls upgraded. We gave me 400 prestige. So I'm now belong to the upper class. I'm part of the gentry. Now, right now, I do not hold any title, but being part of the gentry, I do believe now I can walk into the castles without without having to bribe the guards. Prince Anne the Bastard, Lady Anna. What you can do is you can go ahead and you can bow. My lady! Hello, Henry. What brings you here today? I look for the king. Arrive at castle at the moment. Then we will go there and we will ask him if I can join. Where's Rybeck Castle? It should be somewhere around here, wouldn't it? I think. There it is. There it is. So he's on his... He might be on his way here. Let's head out. Okay, here's a group moving. Where do we have... Do we have the king among you guys? There he is! My lord, king! Even though I despise you a bit, but I'm not gonna say, I have the sword of King Harlus II, and I will at some point take your crown from you. But for now, my lord, I've come to offer my sword in vassalage. Good man, you have proven yourself to be a citizen. The honor of nobility is not yet reserved for you. Do not disturb me with such ridiculous... I just joined the... Fine. I could enlist in his army, but what I can do instead is... Do you have a task for me? Lorena. I cannot be without her, I'm sorry. What I'm going to do, though, is I know that the guy, the Viscount of Suno, has asked me a number of times to be a mercenary for the Svardians. And since the Svardians are now at war with the Merchant Republic of Sindar and the Tsardom, there is possibility for great gains in war. But as you could see, it's not as easy as just joining a kingdom, because even though I've done all this, the king will not accept me. So what we'll have to do until next time is hopefully maybe I will be able to finish and build up this temple. But also, hopefully I will be able to enlist by the aid of the Viscount of Suno, my only friend in this world, the only friend that matters really, of importance, I should say. And hopefully I will be able to join the Svardians, and in that way, I think the king, the reason why he did not allow me, even though I'm part of the gentry, I'm well known in tournaments, I've fought and I've cleared out bandits and so on, he still denies me because he resents, he still has the grudge because of my father. Even though I've done all these things for this bastard, he still will not grant me my birthright. And in the end, I will have to slay this fiend. I will cut his head and put it on a pike. For I will become the true ruler of the Svardian Empire. Anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and hopefully I'll see you guys for the next one. Bye.